Hi there, how you doing? I hope it's alright, and in today's video I'm going to show you how to import a 3D model downloaded from the web and of course increase your Twinmotion user library. So let's get started. The Twinmotion library is immense and has hundreds of thousands of assets available, divided in three different categories: Twinmotion, Quixel Megascan and Sketchfab. Having said that, it is a good idea to have the Twinmotion user library always updated with the 3D models that the Twinmotion libraries are lacking. For example, 3D models of lamps. There are plenty of websites that offer excellent 3D models, free or paid. And this is my absolute favorite. It is called Zeal Project. I filter the search by lighting, flow lamp, and download the model I prefer. What is downloaded is a zipper file with usually three folders inside. The folder with the 3D file to be imported into Twinmotion, the folder with the related texture, and the last one, the folder with the native 3D Studio Max file. Once I have extracted the content of the zipper file, I open Twinmotion, import the 3D model I just downloaded, preferring the FBX format, and apply the materials. I recommend that you use the Twinmotion's library as much as possible to apply material to surfaces, so as to save time. But in this case, for the lamp base, I use the texture in the downloaded zipper file. So I create a new material, apply it to the base, and as the main texture, I assign the downloaded texture. Sometimes it might happen that we download a 3D model with only textures-based materials, on which it would be better to insert also textures of normal and roughness, to of course increase realism. However, often, these textures are not included in the download file, and so it will be up to us to create them. To do this, I type on the Google bar normal map generator, open the first result site in the list, enter the texture from which I want to create the normal and roughness textures and download the results obtained. I go back into Twinmotion, import the 3D model, create a new material, apply it to the reference surface, enter the color texture, roughness texture, and last but not least, normal texture. That done, I saved the downloaded and characterized 3D model in the user library, so I can reuse it in any new project. Thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed this tip and tricks Twinmotion video, let me know in the comment what topic you would like to see in the next video. That said, I wish you a good day or evening, and see you in the next video. Ciao!